Hello, I'm Jane Dixon, and this is the WKTV Journal. The 2017 elections have come and gone, with Kentwood residents re-electing Stephen Kempley to a second term as mayor and Emily Bridson as the new First Ward City Commissioner. The rest of the Kentwood City positions, including newcomer Tom McElvey as Second Ward City Commissioner, were unopposed. Also, both the Rapids and the Wyoming Public Schools millage proposals were approved. Passage of the Rapid millage means continuing bus service in both the cities of Wyoming and Kentwood. The Wyoming Public Schools millage will allow the district to invest $79.5 million in infrastructure over the next two decades. Fall has arrived, and the big question on everyone's mind now is what to do with all those leaves. If you live in the city of Wyoming, you have a number of options for disposing of leaves and other yard waste materials. For more, here's WKTV's Joanne Bailey Boersma.
We pick up a lot of leaves, especially this time of the year. Starting about right now, we go probably 1 mile and I have to unload, and that's a 5-yard truck that I have in there.
Leaves in the streets are more than just a cleanup problem, which is why the city of Wyoming has had a policy against placing leaves and grass clippings in the street.
Leaves and grass that get bunched up in your catch basin, then the street all around it gets flooded, causing safety issues. It's also an aesthetic issue. Nobody likes to drive down a street and see windrows of grass or leaves or anything like that. So those are the two reasons that we have this ordinance.
So last spring, the Wyoming City Council decided to put some enforcement strength into its existing policy to discourage leaves being placed in the city streets.
If we notice that you've intentionally placed leaves or grass in the street, we provide you with a notice, and then you have 3 business days to get it taken care of. If it's not taken care of, the city has a private contractor that they work with that will stop by, take care of it, remove it from the street, and then you as a property owner will actually be charged cost plus 100%. If the owner fails to pay it, then that charge actually gets placed against the property on the tax rolls.
However, the city of Wyoming offers a number of leaf and yard waste disposal options for its residents.
Any resident can stop by and drop off their leaves or their brush or their grass clippings. All they have to do is show proof of ownership. The second option is, you see over my shoulder probably some leaf containers, and those are available for rental to our residents, $10 a weeknight and $20 for a weekend. And the third option is the first Saturday in December. The city has a contractor that comes through and actually picks up leaves at your property, provided they're properly placed in a paper bag.
For more information on Wyoming's leaf program, visit the city's website, wyomingmi.gov. Click on Public Works and then go to the section called All About Leaves.
Just a reminder, the curbside pickup for the city of Wyoming is December 2nd. All items must be placed in paper bags and be out by 6 a.m. We're quickly moving into the holidays, which are full of many sweet delights. One of those cooking up something tasty is Wyoming's Master Arts Theater. The company has partnered with the Van Singel Fine Arts Center to present Willy Wonka the Musical, which has WKTV's Hannah Haviland asking, "What's your favorite candy?"
My favorite candy bar is Mounds.
My favorite candy is M&M's.
My favorite candy is Snickers.
My favorite candy is Lindt White Chocolate Truffles.
My favorite candy is Reese's Peanut Butter Cups.
My favorite candy is Kit Kats.
And then there's Nate and Chris Knobloch.
Well, I'm personally subject to the Scrumdilicious Wonka Bar.
This, now, it's so often mispronounced. Say it again.
Scrumdilicious?
No. It's Scrumdilicious.
There's diddly in there.
You gotta put the idly in there with the Scrumdiddlyicious.
The Scrumdiddlyicious bar may not be real, but the Knobloch brothers are real actors in the upcoming production, Willy Wonka the Musical, a first-time partnership between Master Arts Theater and the Van Singel Fine Arts Center.
This one is unique, and not because we don't have community theater, because we have several, which is cool. But this is a special conglomeration when you take two different organizations and they blend their strengths. You've got Master Arts Theater bringing us the script and the direction, and then you've got Van Singel. bringing us everything that they have to offer with the Dan Pfeiffer stage and all of the set pieces and all of their expertise. It's going to be really, really cool, and I think anyone who comes is going to enjoy it.
Willy Wonka was chosen for a variety of reasons, but the primary reason was involvement in the community.
Something that was going to be appropriate for the season with the holidays coming up, and one that was really going to strike a chord that families would enjoy and that they could come and see together.
We figured we could not go wrong with anything that involves kids, candy, and song, and especially too because Willy Wonka is so timeless.
Willy Wonka the Musical is November 30th and December 1st and 2nd at the Van Singel Fine Arts Center. For more information, call 878-6800 or visit vsfac.com.
And another holiday favorite is the annual Santa Parade, hosted by the Wyoming-Kentwood Area Chamber of Commerce.
And we go from 33rd Street to almost 44th Street. We had over 60 floats last year, five bands. We get some of the big Steelcase and Gordon Foods and those kind of trucks, and it's a great event. And one of the ladies on our committee, she works for Goblin Public Schools, and she says, my kids, not her kids at home, but her kids in school, don't get to go to the big parade downtown. And a lot of them can't afford to go to the mall and get a picture with Santa for whatever it costs. We do that for free. So it reaches an area of people that probably would not get to see Santa in that scenario. And I'm fortunate enough to ride in the vehicle that pulls Santa. They don't see me, of course, they see Santa. They're, you know, but the smiles and the pictures from mom and dad and all the things that go on with it, it's just a great community event.
This year's parade will be December 2nd, starting at 10 a.m. on South Division Avenue from 34th Street to Murray Street. Santa will be available for pictures at Brand Sizzlin' Steaks and Sports Grill at 4132 South Division. Other annual holiday events are Wyoming Gives Back, set for December 7th at the Rogers Plaza Mall. The Kentwood Tree Lighting Ceremony, set for December 8th at the Kentwood Richard L. Root Library. And Wyoming's Great Candy Cane Hunt, set for December 9th at the Wyoming Department of Public Safety. This has been Jane Dixon for the WKTV Journal, reminding you to stay connected to your community by visiting WKTVjournal.org.